everyone, we're back. My name is Miss Scarlet Tanager, and we are playing some Final Fantasy X HD Remaster. We are going to...
No!
Oh right, there's a boss fight here. Everyone, did I seriously save it right before a boss fight? I thought I could just go to the temple. Okay then. You know you haven't played a game in a while when you completely forget about a boss fight. Okay, let's do this. Oh wait, I can't flee. Why would I flee? It's a boss fight. You can't flee the boss fight. That's not how science works. Okay, come on, let's do this. Could use Veil for... Okay, that seems kind of useless, but I'm gonna do it anyway because I really need some ability spheres. Those things don't take damage from shit! Okay, kill it! Cause I think I have to kill those first. Okay. Maybe. Might be wrong. Okay, you are going to become Waka real fast. Well, that was rude. What did Lulu ever do to you? Oh, wait, she set you on fire. Could you not? You teach us you're gonna become Kimari because we gotta make sure everybody gets experience points for all this. And kill that. Bonk! And now it's a big thing! Oh dear. And it's got a lot of tentacles. Actually, those are just arms. Those aren't tentacles. Sort of. I don't even know.
White magic.
Let's throw a haste on Lulu because then she can just use fire constantly. Since that's what it's weak to. Fuck! Best way to kill something. Throw haste on the person who can easily use abilities to kill it. Okay, you've got that, so I'm gonna switch you up for Yuna. Yuna. Here. Lulu's in a bit of trouble, and she heal Lulu. And like that, with a little bit of a spiral cut action, it's dead. I'm probably gonna edit the hell out of that fight down because watching random battle fights isn't entertaining. It's just boring. It's repetitive. I mean, it's fun to play, but it's repetitive to watch. You okay there, Titus?
Yes.
Sorry about that. Hope to break you in a little slower.
Yeah, well, you failed.
Being a guardian's tiring.
You handle yourself pretty well. You got talent.
Nah.
You didn't
so
say nah.
What are these sin spawn anyway?
Fiends. They fall from Sin's body and are left behind in its wake.
Leave him alone and Sin comes back for him. You gotta be quick.
That moment when Waka told me I had talent in battle. I think that was when I started seriously considering becoming a guardian.
Well, yeah, he obviously has talent in battle, seeing as he, you know, just picked up the sword that Orin gave him just apropos of nothing and suddenly knows how to use it.
So, they got also fiends in Xanarcan too?
Just a few. It's a big deal when one shows up, though. Hey! Since one of you believe me about Xanarcan anyway?
I've been thinking. Maybe people Sin gets to don't die. Maybe Sin carries them through time. Like 1,000 years through time.
That's not how it works, Waka.
And then one day, maybe they just pop back, see?
That's not how it works, Waka.
Amazing. Simply amazing.
Hmm?
You make up one theory after another, refusing to face the simple truth. Sin didn't take Chapu anywhere. Sin crushed him and left him on the Jose shore. Your brother won't just pop back.
Lulu! Lulu, please!
Oh, and one more thing. No matter how much you want it, no one can take Chapu's place. No one can replace Sir Jekt, for that matter. And there's no replacement for Lord Braska, either. It's pointless to think about it. And sad.
Okay, that was... in the beginning, she was, you know, justified. You know, Chapu's fine. But
I could never be what Chapu was.
She's a little bit too far there.
Stuff happens. Best not to worry.
Waka, Lulu, and Waka's brother, Chapu. Something had happened between them a long time ago. I was sure of it.
Well, yeah, he's dead.
Well, whatever it was none of my business, that's for sure. Best not to go there.
Temple! And now, fun music. Gonna get ourselves a fire Aeon. Mr. Ifrit. Tea is good. It makes everything better. It is the best of things. Hello. I didn't pay this people to come here. You come here just to find famous people. Uh-oh. I'm gonna have to beat you up, aren't I? Actually, I know I'm gonna beat you up. And your little boob circle moon things.
You here to pray for victory too?
Us pray? Who needs to pray? The Luka goers always win.
Wow.
Oh, yeah? Then why are you here?
Jackass.
We've been praying for some competition this year. So what's your goal this time? You gonna do your best again? Ha! It's too bad your best isn't good enough. Why even bother showing
up? These guys are such jackasses.
We play to win. Ooh, play away. Just remember, even kids can play, boys.
See you in the finals!
That is what we call a sore winner, aka...
We'll beat them.
A jackass.
We have to.
You know that team?
Putting people down? They're as bad as my old man.
See?
But Sir Jekt was a kind and gentle man.
Well, not my Jekt. Even 10 years after he left. Just thinking
good.
About
I
my
just
old
woke
man
up,
got
guys,
me
I
angry.
Needed to wake up.
But maybe that was just my way of keeping him. Nah.
This is the tea thing. The best way to drink tea is loose leaf tea being strained in a strainer. Tea bags are good and all if you just need a quick fix, but loose leaf tea, that's where it's at. Right, there's nothing in there. Anything in here? Nope. Well, let's go get ourselves another summon, which means we're going to have to go through another puzzle. Great. Hi, Yuna.
Please, let Waka's prayers be heard.
Praying, don't you?
I think Waka needs to do a little more praying.
Lord O'Holland, guide our feet.
Feet doesn't do much. You're swimming when you play Blitzball. I mean, you propel yourself with your feet, but seems like that's not necessarily the most important part. There we go. Tea's done. Tea's over. Hi, Donna.
What summoner are you?
She looks like her head's broken. Just like Intentu.
My okay. name is Yuna. From the Isle of Bisade.
Donna? So, you're High Summoner Braska's daughter. That's quite a name to live up to. My.
Bartello looks like he has no eyes.
These people are your guardians? My, what a rabble. As I recall, Lord Braska had only two guardians. Quality over quantity, my dear. Whatever were you thinking?
Donna! Donna, please!
I have need of only one guardian. Right, Bartello?
I only have as many guardians as there are people I can trust. I trust them all with my life. To have so many guardians is a joy and an honor. Even more so than being my father's daughter.
Yeah, you tell her! You're
of
not
course,
in that placid,
I would
nice
never
girl
think
voice of
yours. Questioning your ways either. So, Lady Donna, I ask of you, please leave us in peace.
It's like the nicest possible
you
way to tell somebody
you
to get
want.
The fuck out.
Bartello, we're leaving.
Bartello, we're leaving. Every time he says that, I want to giggle, because he's sort of the same inflection and the same tone of voice every time. But you're leaving.
A guardian is someone a summoner can rely on. Someone she can trust with her life. I wondered, did Yuna feel that way about me?
Obviously, because she asked you to be her summoner. What's she smiling about? Because she loves you.
Lord O'Holland, guide our feet.
Yeah, okay, bro. You have fun with that. We're leaving. Even though I'm technically not supposed to go in here because I'm not technically a guardian yet.
The faith is below. Let's do it.
Do it.
The faith?
But first, the Cloister of Trials. Kamari, Waka, ready? Strength, everyone.
See, at the moment she only has three guardians, which is just one more than Braska had. Technically four if you include Tidus, but he's not a guardian yet.
Duh. Hey, what gives?
You're not a guardian yet.
We'll be back as soon as we can, okay?
Did you guys forget what happened on Besaid?
Oh, sure. Yuna wasn't soon, able to like tomorrow soon, I bet.
Yuna wasn't able to become a summoner until Tidus was there. Nobody's put two and two together yet? Yeah, I guess I'm leaving. It's not letting me leave. I mean, I know why it's not letting me leave, but still not letting me leave. La 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 la.
Where's Yuna?
She's down in there.
Then why are you here?
I'm not a guardian yet.
Hey, I'm not a guardian, so I'm not supposed to go in, right?
Not a guardian, you say?
Hey, wait!
I love how Bartella just immediately assumes what Donna wants to do. She doesn't even say.
Go! Just... Hey! What's a big idea?
Just a little game.
Doesn't even say it, just Bartella immediately assumes. Throw Tidus onto the teleporter thing. Or elevator.
This is bad. Really bad.
Oh, you've already done it once before, Tidus. It's fine. Go. Wait here. I love how it gives you an option to wait.
Only guardians allowed. And I'm sure no guardian.
Oh, you went on there during... Or you went through the temple during Besaid. It's fine.
Well, I guess it's too late now.
I love how they get so angry when he's here for... When he's here on, Ifrit's temple. But they just... Blase, just... Nobody really cared except for the stay away from the summoner lady when they were on Besaid. But no. All of a sudden... They actually start listening to the rules. Like, oh no, he's not supposed to be here. Not like you really gave a shit during Besaid. Okay. Let's do the puzzle. Oh, that don't go through fire. Fire is bad. Also, how quickly did Yuna and everybody manage to get through the temple that has already managed to reset in like the 1.5 minutes? Between Tidus being up there and Tidus coming down here. Okay. We'll put that there. Alright, that doesn't help. I put it there. Ah, there we go. That's what I was looking for. I take that. The glyph repels you! The power of glyph propels you. It just makes me think the power of Christ compels you. Touch the glyph. You know this music? The temple music from Final Fantasy X? It kind of reminds me of the music from Final Fantasy VII, if you think about it. Like, there's something about it that reminds me of Final Fantasy VII. Okay, how do I do this? I think I know which sphere has to go there. I think it's the normal glyph sphere, maybe? It's been a couple years since I played this. this one goes over here. Now, we're not going to go onwards, because technically we could just take one of the Killika spheres and just run onwards. But we are not going to do that, because... We're not going to do that, because we still have to do the destruction sphere. And if we don't do the destruction sphere, then we're going to have a hard time getting Anima later. Okay, destruction sphere goes... Destruction sphere goes somewhere. Destruction sphere goes on here. I don't have to use this thing, but I can't... Oh, right, it has to go onto the little glowy thingy, doesn't it? I think? Maybe? Might be wrong, it's Tidus! God damn it, Tidus! Tidus? Tidus? Tidus, I swear to God. Okay, thank you. Sometimes pushing things in this game can be rather difficult. And now we get a lovely view of Tidus's butt here. His polygonal... What was it, 2000? When this game originally came out, I think? Yeah, that old school boo. But yeah, this song definitely sounds like something from Final Fantasy VII. I can't put my finger on which song specifically- No, Tidus, goddammit! I can't put my finger on specifically which song it sounds like, but it definitely sounds like a song from Final Fantasy VII. If you guys can think of the song that I'm thinking of- Oh! Wait a minute! It sounds like the forest temple song from Final Fantasy VII. That's the one that it sounds like. Okay. It didn't do anything. Oh, I probably have to put a Killika sphere there, don't I? Oh, well, let me switch them! Ah! You can't just pick up one sphere and replace it with the other one. You have to do 5 billion other things first. Okay. I'm gonna take this. And then we put a Killika sphere there, and then we use the other Killika sphere to open the door. There we go! And then there should be- Aha! That's what we needed! And then I take that and I put the destruction sphere there. I'm assuming. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put this guy here. Because I might as well. I mean, we're gonna have to do it anyway. Boom! Everything's on fire! Okay, I'll run back and get the destruction sphere, put it in the hole, and then puzzle is done. Both puzzles, because there's two of them. And you have to do all of the destruction sphere ones in order to get Anima. Which is the most badass of the summons. The only one that might be more badass, I think, is the Maga Sisters, but at least you can control Anima, and you can't directly control anything the Anima Sisters do. You just give them suggestions, which they may or may not actually listen to. Hey, look, a blue wall! You know, I wonder who has to go through the temple and, like, reset all of the puzzles and fix everything. Because I literally just blew this wall up. Just... Nobody cares. Okay. Okay, now let's go piss off Lulu! Because Lulu gets angry at everything. Hi, guys!
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
What's up, nerds?
It was Donna and that big muscle-head man.
Yuna will be the one to suffer the consequences.
You weren't angry when I was there.
What consequences?
She could be excommunicated.
She could be excommunicated. Well, maybe you should have gotten angry when the same damn thing happened on the Seid. Again, you're idiots. Hey, stop being rude, Kamari. Hi, Lou.
The chamber beyond is a sacred place. Only summoners may enter.
Tell that to later in the game when I enter, like,
even guardians can't go?
It's taboo.
Oh.
We break a lot of taboos in this game, Walker.
Just wait. Just...
So what's in there anyway?
The faith, remember?
No.
Oh yeah, that thing, right.
The Faith are people who gave their lives to battle sin. Yevon took their souls, willingly given from their still living bodies.
Huh?
Now, they live forever, trapped in statues. But when a summoner beckons, the souls of the Faith emerge once again. That's what we call an Aeon.
The summons!
All that in this room? So what's Yuna doing in there?
She prays with all her heart for a way to defeat sin.
So she just prays. Just pray and you get magical powers. That's how it works. Oh, don't you look at me in that tone of voice, Lulu.
Just wait.
I don't wanna. I'm leaving. I love this. I absolutely love this. She is exhausted. Falling over. She's been in there for like less than 5 minutes.
There was something I didn't tell anyone else that day.
But
that song we heard there in the temple, I knew it from my childhood. It was proof that Spira and Xanarkin were connected. Somehow. At least to me it was.
I love how he puts
maybe
this out now and not
suddenly,
in the state.
I felt like I just wanted to go home. I tried to say something to tell them, but the words wouldn't come.
But as I was saying, Yuna is exhausted and she falls over, but she's been in there for maybe 5 minutes doing nothing but praying. And we've seen what the praying looks like in this game. How is she that exhausted? I mean, you know, in Besaid, it kind of makes sense because she's apparently been in there for an entire day. But she was in there for less than 5 minutes, if that. Okay, Ifrit. We now have ourselves an Ifrit. And now everybody's gonna want a demonstration of the summoning. Or not. It's once! And then he just stands there and then he runs away, I assume. Yuna's a celebrity! And then he flashes back to him being a celebrity.
I thought I had put my feelings for Xanarkin behind me.
Obviously not, or you won't be flashing back, silly.
But they were there, and they grew inside me bigger and bigger.
What is he even doing? He's just
I was just about ready to burst.
Shepherd dancing or something. Tidus and Shepherd, both horrible dancers.
Are you okay?
I don't know.
What do you want to do?
To scream real loud?
He just does it and nobody brings it up again. Oh, you guys are so silly. Okay. I probably should have saved or done something. Oh, can I get you a save point? Maybe. Can I go backwards? I want to touch that save point. Because my characters are not happy in terms of their health right now. Okay, there we go. Hey, Lulu, you are going to go this way. Wait. Yes, that is the correct direction. I had to make sure. Waka. Do we want him to go this way? That would put him in the same path as Orin usually would go on. Which would definitely make him better than... Okay, where you at, bro? But having access to things like silence attack is good. Decisions. Okay, now you need to move up here. Get power and monas. I do really like the leveling up system in this game. It's a little bit odd, I will admit. Because, you know, you get to choose what kind of character you have. I could totally have Tidus be a black mage if I wanted to. Which is the weird part, but it's also a fun part, too. What else I can send you? Okay, Kimari is there. How about I send him along the same path as Waka and then have him turn to Orin? I like that idea. Yeah. And everybody's leveled up! Good. Now we get to run back and hopefully nothing bad happens while we are in Kilika. Granted, I don't actually remember anything bad happening until we get to Luca, so there's that at least. And now we should be back in Kilika. Yay, Kilika! And then we need to get back onto the boat and go to Luca. And nothing bad could happen on the boat. At least not this time, no, I'm dead serious. Nothing bad happens on the boat this time. Let's go.
Off to Luca at last.
Yeah!
The matches start soon as we get there, so rest up on the way, yeah?
That seems kind of silly, that they don't give people time to rest once they get to Luca. It's like, no, you're off the boat, immediately go into a Blitzball match. Oh, I'm gonna play Blitzball! Oh, I hate Blitzball! I hate this minigame so much. But I'm gonna have to at least do two matches of it. I think it was two. Maybe. Oh, even the Luca goers are like, let's go talk to Yuna! Maybe we can steal her away. Riveting gameplay. We're not allowed to hear what they're saying. Yet. They need to go have a private discussion about their future baby that is also invisible. No, really, Lulu is pregnant in Final Fantasy X-2. Like, straight up pregnant. But you see no baby. Her stomach is completely flat and she's still wearing a corset. You see no baby, yet she's apparently pregnant and gives birth during the game. It's one of the funniest things. Okay. Chess! Looking for someone in particular. Trying to- Ah, there he is!
Ooh, them fascinating clothes you're wearing.
Hiya, Waka.
Yeah! Filthy! Filthy! These won't sell. All me name's not Awaka.
Hey! Rude. My clothes are fabulous. I don't know what you're talking about.
Don't look like you got much money, either. I've no business with you. Out of me way!
Who do you think you are?
Awaka the 23rd. Merchant extraordinaire.
Super rude, man.
Awaka the who?
Wow, suddenly no voice acting.
But someday, the name Awaka will be...
Yeah, I don't care, Awaka. A bit of gil to lend? Wait, why do I want to lend you money again? I can't remember. Ah, screw it, you can have it.
I'll make it up to... I'll make it up to...
What do you have?
Thank you.
He's cut crap. I'm gonna sell stuff to him, then. No, wait, I can't sell anything good. Ah! Damn it. I know that I need to go talk to the captain, or at least I need to go into the captain's room because there is a Albed primer in there. I knew I remembered some things. It might have been a long time, but at least I remember something. Okay, now it's time for... Bear back. Sorry, I needed to pop a save because if I mess this up, I'm gonna have to do it again because I don't want to have to come back onto the ship. Can I not? Oh wait, I thought I had to... balls. There's something else I have to do, isn't there? Okay, let's go talk to Yuna. Yuna! I love you!
What y'all talking about?
Who are you supposed to be? Ah, I remember him. Guy from Killika.
Yep. Huh? One is gonna kick your ass.
You know, one of the Besaid Aurochs. Said something about winning the cup.
Oh, right. You're that idiot.
Don't call him that.
Yeah!
But he is an idiot.
They don't know
what it takes to win the cup.
Well, they do now that I'm here.
Yes, they will win. He used to be the star player of the Xanathan Apes.
Yuna! Jesus, not the time!
Yeah, as if anyone lived in those ruins.
It's not ruins. There's a big city there. There is.
Yuna, you're not helping.
I got too close to Sin and...
There is a city, really.
Yuna.
Right. Whatever your ladyship says.
Yuna's really not helping, and she... Yuna, you're not the smartest girl in the gen. Yuna, please.
What's wrong? You seemed kind of mad back there.
They were being rude, and... I do believe your Xanarkand exists. I really do, you know?
How come?
Sir Jekt used to always tell me stories. It'd be great to see your home someday.
Used to always tell him stories, huh?
I'd love to go there.
But you only knew him for a day.
So, Yuna, want to come over to my place? Right. Sure. As if I had a place to show her.
Hey, Yuna, you want to come over to my place?
I do believe your Xanarkand exists.
Okay, then. Can I do the thing now? Oh, come on, the Blitzball is just sitting there. Let me kick the Blitzball around. No, we have to do more cutscenes first. Waka!
Say something.
Lulu!
You'll take responsibility.
Relax, he's bound to know someone in Luca.
And if not?
He could always join a Blitz team. Anyhow, it's better than just leaving him in Besaid.
What? Just leaving him in Luca?
What do you want me to do?
Yuna wants to make him a guardian.
Oh, yeah, jeez. There's that too, eh?
I mean, Yuna does get final say here.
Whose fault is that?
Not mine! It is mine, huh?
Yes, Waka, it is. Totally your fault.
Why do you think she wants to make him a guardian anyway?
Because he's Sir Jack's son.
All right. Wait. You sure about that? He's really Sir Jack's son.
It's hard to say, but Yuna seems to believe so.
Okay.
That's all you have to say?
And now Lulu gets mad.
Yeah, I mean, he's gotta decide for himself, yeah? Well, him and Yuna, I guess.
Well, it helps if you tell them the truth about the pilgrimage.
I wonder which is best.
Go back up.
Why don't you tell him he should?
Should what?
Become Yuna's guardian.
Why me?
Because Yuna can't.
Why not?
He hates his father. What he was, what he did. Do you really think she can possibly say to him, I want you to be my guardian, like your father was to mine?
Aren't you being oversensitive? All right. I'll try talking to him after the tournament.
All Lulu has to do is sigh.
I know. It's his decision.
Yeah, well, that decision kind of gets taken away from him, so...
He doesn't like his father.
Apparently, he told Yuna as much.
Hating your own father, huh? Sounds like a luxury to me. I don't even remember my parents. Can't say how I feel about them.
I was five then, so I remember mine a little.
Damn it!
How dare you remember
Sin
your parents,
just takes
Lulu.
Everything away from us.
Is that it? Hi, Waka. Are you done?
Go to bed, bud.
I don't want to go to bed. It's only
someone's bound to recognize
55.
You when they see our moves out there, huh?
It's only 1:55. I don't want to go to bed. I'm trying to talk to you, child. Come here. I know who you are. You become a person that's important later. Gosh darn it, Nappa.
I do believe you're Xanarchy.
Yeah, I don't care, Yuna. Okay, let's see how hard this is. Now I get to do the blitz ball thing. There we go. Okay, let's hope I don't screw this up and have to reload. Because that would suck. Whoa, his eye just... I'm gonna have to zoom in on that because his eye just, like... His pupil just pulled apart for a second. I have to zoom in to show you guys that, if I remember to do so, at least. How did you miss the ball and fall over? That takes a special kind of stupid. Hijacked.
Well, well. Trying to follow in my footsteps, are you? I usually charge for lessons, you know. That shot is done like this. You can't do it, kid. But don't worry, my boy. You're not the only one.
Seems overly complicated for a blitzball shot.
I'm the best.
I just noticed something about Waka, or about Tidus and Jack. They both wear big ol' arm gauntlets, and they're almost the same, especially down by the arm. They almost wear the same gauntlet. Oh, I years that I have known and played this game, and I've never noticed that. Okay. Oh boy. Okay, let's do this. I'm gonna have to focus. Just zen. Just focus.
You're out of your league.
No one else can do it.
Best.
No one else can do it.
You can't
You're out
do
of your
you
league.
Can't do it, kid. You can't do
no
it.
No one
kid.
Else can do it.
No one else can do it.
No! No! Total. No! No! Did I do it? Did I do it? Yeah! Third time's a charm. Yes, it took me three times. And now I get victory chocolate. Ah.
The best? Yeah, right.
Huh? Hey, Tidus. It took you three tries, so
whoa.
Shut up.
What's that called?
Doesn't have a name. Anyone can do it if they try.
Show us one more time, yeah?
See, I needed to learn this one because it makes the blitzball stuff in Luca so much easier. Come on, Tidus. You got this, bro. Hi, Uni. Love
that
the face.
That was the checked shot, wasn't it?
It's this really good chocolate peanut butter stuff that my best friend's mom made for Christmas.
Sir Jack showed it to me
so
when I was
good.
A child.
It's like crack.
He called it the sublimely magnificent Jekt Shot Mark III.
Huh. It's a terrible name.
Stupid name, huh? You know what? There is no Mark I or Mark II, you know? My old man said the name Mark III was just something to hook the crowd. He said they'd come back
Everyone
every night
you know
expecting to see
game.
Mark 1 and Mark 2. And they really did come back. I used to get so mad.
Why? Because your dad was popular? That's a dumb reason to get mad.
Is he alive, you think?
I don't know. But Sir Jekt was my father's guardian.
So he's famous here, too?
Yes. So, if anything happened to him, I should think word would get around fast.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, about that, Yuna.
What would you do if you found him?
Who knows? I thought he died 10 years ago. Well...
Punch him in the face!
I'd probably just smack him one.
Yeah!
After everything he put Mom and me through. And because he was famous, I was always... Well, you should know, Yuna.
Hmm?
Your father's famous, too. Everyone in Spira knows him, right?
Hmm.
Ain't it tough?
It is hard to follow in his footsteps as a summoner.
Sure.
But the honor of having a father like him surpasses all that, I think.
Well, there wasn't much to honor about my old man, that's for sure.
You he was a drunkard that about and your father? Shoot up.
I got the right.
I guess you do.
Got drunk and stabbed Shoe Pup. That's the kind of man
Show
the Jekt
me
is.
That move again!
Yo! I didn't think my old man would come to Luca. He never did like watching other people play. But I couldn't help feeling something bad was gonna happen. And these feelings of mine are usually right. Sure, I had told Waka I'd help him win the tournament, but I wasn't sure I had it in me to play at all anymore.
I'm a similar way. I didn't have really good intuition. I have this feeling that something bad's gonna happen. Generally, something bad happens. It's not a good thing. Like, if I'm at a convention, I'm like, I have a really bad feeling about this. I have a really bad feeling about this party or this convention. Then, inevitably, something terrible happens at the convention. Or, you know, everybody just gets really stressed. You know, the more I play this game, the more I think that I'm actually shocked that Sin never attacks Luca. I mean, look at that! Granted, they explain that the Crusaders protect it, but the Crusaders can't protect anything. Like, the you see later that the Crusaders can't do anything against Sin, so why is Sin not demolished Luca already?
Ah, over there! The ships carrying the players are arriving now! This would be dock number 2! All the way from Killika, it's the Killika Beasts!
Good thing none of them died when Sin wrecked the place.
Holland used to play for them, a big name to live up to. Their hometown was recently attacked by Sin, isn't that right, Jimin?
Yes, Baba, they're gonna be pulling out all the stops to try and bring back the cup this year.
Baba and Jimin.
Isn't it, folks? Our next team off the ramp is... Well, 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 if it isn't the Besaid Aurochs! They're a living, breathing, statistical impossibility! I've never seen a team this bad!
Oh my god!
That's right! In 23 years, they've never made it past the first round!
Rude!
Only a few die-hard fans are in the audience today.
Best of luck to them and a safe journey back to Besaid.
Right, Jimin. Moving right along.
They are so rude.
Our next team is...
So rude.
Here they are, folks. Our very own Luca Goers.
What are the Luca Goers doing in Killika, anyway?
They've got power, they've got speed, they've got teamwork. They're an all-round first-class
And they've got home field
advantage. Back home in Luca.
Without a doubt, they are the favorite this year, Baba.
So we're gonna kick their ass, right?
The way they dominated last year, it'd take a miracle for them to lose today.
You You can say that again.
Or the power of reloading saves.
Look at the crowd. Looks like all of Luca has turned out to cheer the goers on. They know, I know, and you know, folks. The Luca goers are number one.
Wow, talk about bias.
Yeah, it's like this every year, yeah? Don't let it
bias in
you.
Journalism. And then Titus does something rash, like usual.
Stop right there, goers! You guys are smiling now!
Damn it, Titus. Where did he get a megaphone?
This year, us Aurochs are taking the cup!
What in heaven's name were you doing up there?
We sure stood out, though. We were on the sphere.
We were?
Maester Micah is here.
Already?
The number three dot!
What's up now?
Maester Micah has arrived, that's what.
Micah?
Maester?
Maester Micah is the leader of all the peoples of Spira. He's come all the way from Bavel. The tournament is being held to honor his 50 years as Maester.
50
Old
years?
People.
Shouldn't he be, retired by now?
Hey, mind your mouth now.
Let's all go see him.
Sure, because this is going to end splendidly. And by that I mean rather poorly. Because we get to meet the not creepiest man alive.
Can't see a thing.
Really? You're taller than everybody there, Titus. There's no way those six people are making that music. There are many, many more instruments than what is present. Oh boy, here he is. The creepiest man in Final Fantasy.
Who could it be?
Isn't that Maester Seymour?
I have a story about him. I have a story about Seymour. Not sure if I should tell it, though. But I'm good anyway. So, my friend Gina, she is Riku Grape. She's a cosplayer. Gina and I loved this game. But she would always name Titus, Turtus, funnily enough. Because she hated Titus.
Given of spirit, I thank you for your generous welcome.
Rise, she absolutely Maester hated Seymour. Seymour, though.
And all
she
of
was
you as
well. So creeped out by him.
I present to you the son of Maester Jiskel Guado, who departed for the far plain a fortnight past. As some of you already know, he has been officially ordained a Maester of Yevon.
I am Seymour Guado. I am honored to receive the title of Maester.
In life, shut up, Seymour. Nobody likes you.
My father Jiskel worked to foster friendship between man and Guado. I vow to carry on his legacy and to fulfill my duties as Maester to the best of my abilities.
So. Anyway,
you too. Bow your head.
Damn it, walk up. So my friend Juno was so terrified and so creeped out by Seymour. She just thought him like the creepiest, sleaziest, greasiest man alive. She hated Seymour so much that one year for I think it was Christmas or something.
He sets you up, yeah. All right, last
we started getting a
the
joke.
Hustle.
Walk up, shut up. We started joking that Seymour lived in Gina's bed. Now, the joke came because her username, Riku Grape, she was a Riku cosplayer, and we started joking around about a slash fic that paired Riku and Seymour, or just joking about Riku and Seymour getting together, and somehow that evolved into Seymour sleeping underneath my friend Gina's bed, So we would constantly make jokes in high school about Gina's boyfriend and kept asking her how her boyfriend was doing, even though she would just get this look of horror on her face every time we brought it up. So that is the story how my friend Gina, aka Riku Grape, met her husband. AKA all of us making fun of her for hating Seymour so much. Yeah, it's a weird story. I was weird in high school. I was a little weird. Little messed up in the head.
Where's Waka?
What?
At the matchup draws.
We had to play the Gores in the first match last year.
The year before that, and the one before that, too.
Well, we would have lost to anyone anyway.
Captain Waka!
We're playing the Albed Sykes first. If we win, we're in the finals. That's right, we got seeded! 2 wins, and we're the champions. First things first. Let's go over the basics again, boys.
I know how to play Blitzball. Don't make me go through a tutorial if I'm playing this game for an hour already. No. Stupid Blitzball. Stupid video game. Yeah, Titus has the right idea.
There you are. Someone said they saw Sir Orin in a cafe.
Orin?
Yes, Sir Orin. Let's go find him.
Hey! Hey! The game starts like real soon. You come back quick, yeah?
Hey, I'll be back.
Yeah, okay.
He just lets it go.
Hey,
come back. Go.
You're stiff,
I'll be back.
Man.
Yeah.
No, not your face.
Yeah.
Just breathe out. Relax.
Okay.
Like this. Just breathe. Yeah.
Waka's a little tense. Maybe Lulu should give him a back rub.
Maybe now we can find Sir Jekt.
Huh? How?
I think Yuna has a crush on Jekt.
Sir Orin was also my father's guardian. So, he might know where Sir Jekt is. Let's go now.
Then maybe we should stop talking and start moving.
It didn't even occur to me to think that the Orin Yuna was talking about, and the one that I knew from Xanarkin could be 2 different people. I don't know why, but I knew it was the same guy. I knew it was the same Orin.
Well, how common is the name Orin, really? Can I look through these? Play to win, I don't even care. Can I look through these yet? No? Okay. I know there's something important for Waka in one of the lockers, for his ultimate weapon. But that is going to be it for this video, you guys. In the next one, we will play some Blitzball. I will cry because I hate the Blitzball minigame. And I will see you all in the next video.